So you've been keeping a planted aquarium for a little while, and you're on the fence about trying fertilizers. This is the video for you. Welcome back to the Boost Plant channel. My name is Logan with Team Boost Plant, and today we got our full breakdown on aquarium plant fertilizers. We're gonna break down why we fertilize, the science of fertilizers, as well as recommend lots of great products to get you started with ferts. Even if you're a little bit more advanced when it comes to aquarium plant fertilizer, you may learn something you don't know, as well as some pro tips. So stick around to the very end. We've got lots of cool stuff coming in this video. But before we get started, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel for lots of cool educational content like this. Why do we fertilize? Just like humans, plants need nutrients to thrive. And if you can give them a balanced nutritional diet with a healthy fertilizer and substrate, they're gonna really thrive. Just like if you're an athlete, you wanna make sure your body gets everything it needs to operate in optimal condition. Just like humans, plants acquire nutrients via macronutrients and micronutrients. So they take up macros in the largest amounts. And macronutrients are made up of hydrogen, carbon, oxygen, nitrogen, potassium, calcium, magnesium, phosphorus, and sulfur. Micronutrients are nutrients that your plant uses in smaller trace amounts. These include chlorine, iron, boron, manganese, zinc, copper, and finally, molybdenum.
How do plants get their nutrients?
There's two methods for delivery that work in conjunction with one another. First is a nutrient-rich substrate, and for this, we recommend UNS Comfra Soil. It's got lots of nutrients that your plant's roots need to really thrive. Plants do a lot of feeding from their roots, and the individual granules on the soil are porous because they're made of clay, which gives them something called a high cation exchange capacity, aka CEC. And essentially what that boils down to is they're porous and have a lot of surface area, so the roots of the plants and all the little micro hairs and fibers on those roots can easily absorb the nutrients that are stored in the soil. And we also provide nutrients in the water column through dosing so that the leaves of the plants can absorb the nutrients. There's significant data and evidence that suggests using both of these methods in the planted aquarium hobby together with one another are going to produce the very best results for your plants. Every 6 months or so, feel free to refresh your soil with root tabs that are going to provide more nutrients to those roots. But the dosing can be a little more complex. So let's dive into that topic.
Fertilizer dosing methods.
So there are three main schools of thought when it comes to dosing liquid nutrients into your tank. But for each method, the composition of the nutrients are different. But first, let's talk about the method that we recommend most beginners start with, which is the balanced or complete method. With this method, you're using a fertilizer that essentially has all the macronutrients your plants need, all the micronutrients your plants need, but not in excess. Your plants are getting just enough of what they need without building up a ton of excess waste organics. So the best part about this method is you're providing your aquarium plants with everything they need, but you don't have to do a massive water change every week. However, we do still recommend at least a 30% change every week or every other week to reset those nutrient levels. Next up, let's discuss the lean or nitrate limitation method of dosing. This is a method that is often used to manipulate your plants to bring out deeper, more vibrant reds. And it essentially reduces or completely eliminates the nitrates in your aquarium fertilizer. So there's significant evidence as well as anecdotal results that suggest limiting nitrates in your aquarium regimen can cause your plants to stress a little bit and essentially produce more anthocyanins, resulting in deeper, more vibrant reds. So if you want to experiment with this, you can go ahead and try the lean method. One of the great pros of this method is by reducing nitrates, you'll often also see less risk of algae. However, you run a higher risk of your green plants being nutrient deprived. So you want to watch this one really carefully and monitor your plant health and dose accordingly. If you find that your plants are really suffering, you're going to probably want to get more nitrates into your dosing regimen, as it's one of the macros that plants use to thrive. And the final method we're going to discuss is the estimative index, or the EI method of dosing. This method was developed and popularized by planted aquarium expert Tom Barr. And the theory behind it is that you're giving your aquarium plants an excess of macro and micronutrients so that they have everything they need, no questions asked. However, by providing your plants with an abundance of nutrients, you're gonna build up an excess over the course of a week, and you're gonna wanna reset that once a week with a heavy 50% or more water change. So that can be a big turnoff for a lot of planted aquarium hobbyists who aren't too keen on doing a lot of maintenance. But if you're somebody who's already getting their hands in there and you've got a great water change system and you want fast, explosive, colorful results, the EI method might be great for you. Finally, it's worth noting that calcium and magnesium are two very important elements that your plants need to thrive as well. And these commonly come from your tap water. But if you're using RO water, it's important to remineralize. So number one, make sure your GH and your KH and your TDS are optimal for the life in your tank, but also to make sure your plants are getting enough calcium and magnesium. So go ahead and check out the water quality report if you're using tap. And if you're using RO, go ahead and check out our video all about water parameters and how to achieve the optimal water parameters for a planted aquarium. We'll link that video down below in the video description.
When to dose fertilizers.
As with most things in this hobby, there's lots of different opinions on this. Some folks like to start the day of setup and dose the tank right away. Other people start day one and dose only a lean amount and then ramp up to an excess. Other folks wait a couple weeks. It's worth trying all these methods and seeing what works best for you. However, it is really important to know that in the beginning of a planted aquarium's life cycle, it is prone to algae and the plants aren't necessarily taking up all the nutrients available to them because they're still rooting and developing healthy tissue adapted to your water. So it's worth experimenting with these different methods and just observing the results and make sure not to change too many things at once. So if you're not happy with your results, don't change the lighting, the CO2, and the fertilizer all in one week. Change one parameter at a time, observe for a couple weeks, and then go from there.
What method is best for you?
So you've decided you're gonna start dosing liquid nutrients in your aquarium and you're between the three different dosing methods. So which one is actually best for you? Well, it's really gonna depend on your lifestyle and it's gonna depend on your aquarium goals. Let's say maybe you have a planted aquarium in your business and it has to be low maintenance and always look good and you don't ever wanna run the risk of algae. You're probably gonna wanna stick with either lean dosing or the complete method because you're not gonna wanna have to dive into the tank every week for a 50% water change. Maybe you're somebody who has a bunch of aquariums at home and loves spending time doing maintenance on the weekends for a couple hours. This is a situation where the EI method might be great for you because you're gonna get fast, explosive growth this way. If you're a complete beginner, we recommend starting with the complete method because this will at least ensure your plants have everything they need. If you're unhappy with the speed of the growth, why don't you give EI a try? And if you're trying to keep really vibrant reds, start with the complete and then maybe move into a lean method to see if you could bring out deeper reds without sacrificing the health. It's really important to experiment, try things, stick with them for a while, and then modify from there.
Fertilizer recommendations.
We recommend checking out the Boost Plant website and getting your hands on the Aquario Neo Solutions. If you're more of a DIY person and you live in the US or another country that allows it, you can actually mix your own and get your hands on the individual compounds yourself. However, we don't recommend this for beginners or someone who's not too big on DIY because it is gonna require a lot of research and certain countries actually ban the purchase of those chemicals. Finally, if you wanna spruce up your soil or if it needs a little bit of refresh. We also carry Aquario root tabs. These are going to be great for providing the roots of your plants with everything they need to really thrive. Let us know down below in the comments what your preferred method of fertilizing is, as well as when you start fertilizing your planted aquarium after setup. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Logan with Team Boost Plant. Be sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and recommend the vid to a friend who could use this info. Now get out there and create something beautiful.